गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, प्रीवियस क्लास आई हैव डिस्कस्ड द स्मार्ट सेंसर्स. सो वेयर वी आर गोइंग टू यूज द स्मार्ट सेंसर एंड व्हाट आर द एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ स्मार्ट सेंसर्स एज वेल एज द फाइबर ऑप्टिक ट्रांसड्यूसर्स इट्स वर्किंग. ओके, सो देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ फाइबर ऑप्टिक ट्रांसड्यूसर्स, एक्सट्रिंसिक sensor and intrinsic sensors that we have been discussed. Also we have started the digital transducer. Okay, so digital transducers, in that frequency domain transducers have been completed here. So today we'll see the next topic in the digital transducer, digital encoder. Okay, so then how we are going to use the digital encoder in our sensors and transducers. Okay, so let us start with topic. Okay, so let us first will know, so what is a digital encoder? So digital encoder is nothing but, so it is going to convert the analog signal into digital signal. So it means analog signal may be anything. It may be rotary motion or linear motion. Okay, so it may be in sinusoidal signal or it may be ramp, whatever the signals we have considered that are going to convert into some digital form. Okay, the output should be in a digital form. That is nothing but the digital encoder here. Okay, so in the digital encoder, whatever we are going to consider the digital circuits here, each number are going to combination with some binary digits. Whatever the digital output we are getting now, so those are the combinations of the binary digits. Okay, so then how it is going to combination, and it means how the binary values are going to combined here. A complete group of these combinations, whatever the binary digits are combined now, so those represents the numbers, letters or else the symbols. So for this we'll call it as digital code. Okay, it may be complete group of the combinations which represents the numbers, letters or symbols is called as the digital code. Numbers is nothing but zeros and ones, the combination of 1111 or 101 or 2001. Okay, so these all are the combination of binary digits. No, so those are nothing but the digital codes here. Whatever we are making the group now, so those groups are zeros and ones in the binary number. Okay, so then in present scenario, so whatever we are using the digital equipments, so those are represented with some codes. Those codes are used to represent and process the numerical information. So whatever we are using nowadays, all are digitalized equipments. Okay, so those digitalized equipments will give the digital outputs. We cannot get the analog output in present equipments. Okay, so because that digitalized equipments are converted analog signal to digital values here or digital outputs here. So already I have said that the groups of ones and zeros are the outputs. The navena output in baratala, so output should be in zeros and ones itself. If it is a one, then we have to conclude that, or we have to say that the equipment is on state. Okay, so on state. Okay, if it is a, it is showing one, so then say that the system is in on condition. If the output is zero, then say that the system is in off state. Okay, so these are the two binary values, that is zeros and ones, we are getting as a output here. Okay, so then here one more important factor is there. Whatever we are forming the output zeros and ones now, so those letters are in LSB or MSB. So what is this MSB and LSB? So LSB is nothing but least significant bit, and MSB is nothing but the most significant bit. LSB should be in the right hand side of the equation. So you can see this, for example, this you can see this. So here it is the LSB. So we have to write the LSB in the right hand side, then MSB in the left hand side. Okay, so for example, 11101 is there. You can say that this one will be the LSB here. Okay, then this one will be the MSB, most significant bit. So then this 11101, that is 5 digit output, represents the decimal value of 29. If you are going to elaborate this, so it is in fourth place, third place, second place, one place and zero place. 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 3 and 2 to the power 4. So if you simplify this, you will get the output as a 29. It means 29 is the decimal value of the binary, the group of binary combination, that is 11101. Okay, so this is how we are going to form, or each bit we are going to consider the on and off, or else output as zeros and ones here. Okay, so then there are various types of codes we are going to use here. So which are those different types of codes we are enumerated in representing the output here in the digitalized system equipments here? So those are, so it may be in the BCD code, or XS3 code, gray code, octal code, hexadecimal code. Already you all have know this. Okay, so this has been discussed in the first semester itself. So let us see a little bit of this, what, how the BCD codes are represented as an output here in the digitalized equipment. Okay, so naturally BCD code also familiar as natural BCD code, binary to gray code, we will call it as. Okay, so BCD codes are used as a output in the digital encoder. So naturally we will call it as the BCD, as a natural BCD also, that is binary coded decimal values. So, and it is very convenient for representing the decimal digits in digital circuits. Okay, so BCD is used for the representing the values of decimal digits here. Okay, so it has the, it consists of, that is BCD code consists of 4 bits. Okay, so that is 000 to 1001, representing the decimal numbers from the decimal value 0 to 9. This is the maximum value we are going to use in the decimal values. 0 to 9 is the maximum values, because it, the name only indicates it is a binary coded decimal values. Okay, so that's why the, it should be 0 to 9 itself, that is 10 values it is going to represent here. Okay, so then what is, if you are going to convert the BCD into the binary values, it should be 0002 1001 is the value here. Okay, or so if you are restricted to only BCD, it should be 02111, though then it will be very difficult, you will call it as the 0 to 7 values. Okay, so BCD should be represented with 0022 1001, 0 to 9 here. Okay, so 0 to 9 is the BCD values here, representing the decimal numbers from 0 to 9 here. So whatever the remaining values are there, from 10102 1111, that is 10 to 15 decimal values are there now. So these are the don't care conditions in the BCD values, because we don't, or we are not going to consider in the BCD representation. So as the name indicates, the BCD is nothing but it is only 0 to 9 itself, 0 to 9 the binary coded decimal values here. So that's why 10 to 15, whatever we are going to represent, we are going to neglect those here, okay? So then this code is the very simple but more efficient. Whatever we are getting the output, that should be in a efficient manner. So then next one, it is XS3 code. So XS3 code can be derived from the BCD values. Whatever the output we are getting in the XS3 code, we are derived from the BCD by adding 3 to each coded number. So whatever, for example, if the decimal value is 9, we have to add with 3 here for XS3 code, okay? Then output will be 12, is it right? So then, so same way, we have to add the binary values also. Okay, if you perform the operation here, you will get some output. So that should be similar to the whatever output we are getting here, okay? So whatever the BCD value is there, we need to add the 3 for each coded number here. So then after adding 3, we have to make the 9's complement to get the XS3 code here, okay? So then gray code. So in this gray code, any one bit changes between any two successive numbers, we have to change the one number here. So I will not explain much about the gray code. So already you have know better than me, okay? So there are two operations we need to perform here. We need to convert binary to gray value, or else gray to binary value, or gray to natural code, or gray to BCD, whatever you call it as. So there are certain procedure to follow that. So we need to consider first MSB, and then we have to write the whatever the binary values are there in the most significant bit during the conversion. Then after conversion, we need to convert the gray code to other bits like BCD or XS3 code. Then after converting, we need to simplify it by adding the 2's complement and the 9's complement. So we'll get the output here same way. So when we are going to convert from gray to natural code, we have to apply our we need to apply the some rules here. So that you have go through the textbook here, okay? It's there. So then next one, octal code. Octal is nothing but octo is nothing but the 8, right? The octal system is a 8 base system, so it uses the 3 bits to represent one octal digit, okay? So then hexadecimal code. So hexadecimal system is nothing but, or hexa is nothing but the 16, okay? Its base value should be 16 here. It uses the 4 bits. So 0 to 7 decimal values, we are using 3 digits of binary values here. And 0 to 9 for BCD, we are going to use 4 binary digits here. 0 to 15, we are going to use 4 digits of binary values here, okay? So here hexadecimal is nothing but the 16 value. Here we are going to use the 4 bits of represents the one hexadecimal value, whatever it may be. So if it is a 18 value, hexadecimal values, we need to use the 4 bits of binary values here, okay? So for example, assume that it's a 15. How you are going to represent the 15 in binary bits? 1 1 1 1, okay? So there are 4 bits here, right? So then the hexadecimal digits are represented as a 0 to 1 continued by the alphabetic characteristics, okay? So after 9, that is after BCD values, whatever the decimal values are there, that is 0 to 15, we are going to use some letters here. Standard hexadecimal values are there. So those are A, बी सी डी ई एंड एफ. ओके सो ए इज नथिंग बट द 10, बी 11, 12, 13, 14 एंड 15. सो दीज अल्फाबेटिकल लेटर्स आर यूज्ड इन द हेक्साडेसिमल कोड फॉर ईजी ऑपरेशन ऑफ द हेक्साडेसिमल आउटपुट हियर. सो नेक्स्ट कम्स द description of digital encoders. Whatever the digital encoders we are using, so the description of that. So here in this digital encoders, the contact type arrangement are existing in direct contact between the brushes as well as the encoder disk here. So for example, if it is a one system here, that is digital encoder, and assume that, so this is the encoder disk here. In between these two we need to fix some brushes. Okay, brushes are nothing but here converters. Okay, so don't think much about the brushes. Okay, so brushes are nothing but when we are going to fix some photocells or some converters here. Okay, so then in that there are again two types of encoders are there. So in that first one, optical type encoder. So you can see the arrangement of optical type arrangements here. So it is the non-contact type encoder here. So non-contact encoder type. So when light is, or we are going to use the lamp here as the light source. Okay, so when light source is used or fold on the encoder disk here, so this is the encoder disk, so it is going to scatter the light from encoder disk to slit. Slit is going to converts the lights whatever we are getting from the encoder disk, and so that light is fold on the photocells. So photocell will scatter the light in electrical output like on and off. So if it is whatever we are getting, so these are the number of slots here, so 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. So it is going to shows the output as 1, 0, 1, 1 like that. If it is showing the 1 means that output is on here. So if it is showing 0, so then it is the corresponding output should be in off. Okay, so that type we are going to use the optical type of encoders in digitalized equipments to know the outputs here. So similarly, next one is second one, magnetic type encoder. So this also the non-contact type of encoder. So this type of encoders uses a number of small toroidal magnets here. Okay, so these are the toroidal magnets here. So there are number of small toroidal magnets used in the encoders here. Okay, so here the conducting and non-conducting ones are contact type encoders here. So when the energized signal is fold on the toroidal magnets, so we'll get the output as, so output here. So much so for example, so one of the coil in each toroidal magnet is energized. Okay, so if it is the consider that this magnet is energized here, then it is not only energized with some high effective frequency is also existing here. Okay, in the toroidal magnet here. So if it is energized more means, so let us consider it is a output. So it is not energized, then it should be it showing that 0 here as a output here. So then through that we are going to operate it easily. Okay, so then next one is digital fresher transducers. Okay, so next topic in the digital transducers is digital fresher transducers. So let us consider the block diagram for this. So this is a one set of block diagram. It shows the assembly of the digital fresher transducer. So the block diagram of this is shown here. Okay, so you can consider there are mainly three components they have used here. One is amplifier, so then converter, then microprocessor. These are the three main components here. So in amplifier, so it is going to amplify the outputs here. Okay, amplify the input whatever we are getting from the strain gauge here. So that is amplified by using the free amplifier circuit here. Then whatever the amplified output is fed on the analog to digital converter. So it is convert analog signal to digital converter. So converted output is fed to the microcontroller, microprocessor. Okay, so if it is fine, there is no noise in the output signal, then it will directly goes to the digital display and will get the output here. So it has some noises and distortion in the output signal, so it is going to fed on the microprocessor. Okay, so then microprocessor will manipulate the output here, then it is going to give the output as a control logic. Again it is going to give the output as a 1 and 0 here. Okay, so for example best example enappa antandre idakka, so ond eno ond ide idin telkodri ond ond paper ada, so paper anna nanu turn madbekagaiti, so table mele, so how you are going to turn that paper without touching your hands? So I am going to ಬ್ಲೋ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಉಫ್ ಅಂತ ಓದಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ರೀ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ. ಸೊ ಅವಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಪೇಪರ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಸೊ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅಪ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಹಿಂಗೆ ವೈಬ್ರೇಟ್ ಆಗಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ವೈಬ್ರೇಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇಟ್ ಸಡನ್ಲಿ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗ್ತೈತೆ ರೀ. ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಕರ್ಡ್ ಇಯರ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಸೆಂಬ್ಲಿ ಇಯರ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟರ್ ಅಸೆಂಬ್ಲಿ, ಸೊ ಯುಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ blowing the pressure here or applying the pressure. Initially the whatever we are using the molten metal here, it is in this form. So when you are applying the pressure, it is rotating like this and it stands like that. It means from one state to another state it has been changed when you are going to apply the pressure on the transducer here. That's why the name indicates the digital pressure transducers. So if it is the position as a zero, okay, so call it as this position. So they named it as a zero position. So then it starts converted and gives this output. So this is a one. Okay, so then the output has got 0 to 1 here. The input is a zero and output we have got 1. Okay, so you can change the operation here, vice versa. Okay, so this is about the digital fresher transducers. And next topic is important topic. So selection of sensors. So how you are going to select the sensors, then what are the factors we need to consider for selection of the sensors here? So there are tremendous factors are there for considering the sensors here, depending upon the accuracy, depending upon the range, speed of the sensor and its linearity, its reliability, the cost, availability, requirement, its life, its power supply. Okay, so we have to consider all the factors, because so if we want the less power consumption sensors, you can go for that. Okay, ಸೊ ಬೇಡ ಸರ್ ನಂಗೆ ನಂಗೆ ಲೋ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದು ಬೇಕು, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ಯುವರ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ದ ಸೆನ್ಸರ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಹೌ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ದ ಸೆನ್ಸರ್ಸ್ ಇಯರ್. ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ ಈಸ್ ರೀಸೆಂಟ್ ಟ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸ್ಮಾರ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರೆಷರ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟರ್ಸ್ ಇಯರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಎನಿ ಹೌ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿಯರ್ ವಿತ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರಿಸೀವರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಹೌ ದ ಸ್ಮಾರ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರೆಷರ್ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟ್ ಓವರ್ ಒನ್ ರೀಸನ್ ಟು ಅನದರ್ ರೀಸನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಸ್ಮಾರ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರೆಷರ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಮಾರ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರೆಷರ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟರ್. ಸೊ ಮೈಕ್ರೋ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸರ್ ಆರ್ ನೌ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟ್ ದ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ರೇಂಜ್ ಆಫ್ 4 to 20 milliampere ಆನ್ ಅ 2-wire. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಗುಡ್ ರಿಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಮೆಸರೇಬಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಅ ಸ್ಮಾರ್ಟ್ ಇಂಟೆಲಿಜೆಂಟ್ ಸೆನ್ಸರ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ದ ನೇಮ್ ಇಂಡಿಕೇಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಮಾರ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರೆಷರ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಕ್ವಿಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಮೇಜರ್ ಅಡ್ವಾಂಟೇಜಸ್ ಇಫ್ ವೀ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಮಾರ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರೆಷರ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟರ್ ಓವರ್ ದ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟರ್ ಇಯರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್ ರೇಂಜ್ ರೇಂಜ್ ದೆನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಯುರೇಸಿ 100% ಎಕ್ಯುರೇಸಿ ಆರ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಹೈ ಎಕ್ಯುರೆನ್ಸಿ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಟು ದ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಸೆನ್ಸರ್ಸ್ ವೀ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟರ್. ದೆನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಲೆಸ್ ನಾಯ್ಸ್ ಇಫ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಫೇಸ್ ದ ನಾಯ್ಸಿ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ದೆನ್ ಲೆಸ್ ಕನ್ಸುಮ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಈಸಿಲಿ ಆಪ್ರೇಟ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಸಮ್ ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ರಿಮೋಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೋಸ್ ಸೆನ್ಸರ್ಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಪ್ರೇಟ್ ಬೈ ಸಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಎಟ್ ಹೋಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಎಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಎಕನಾಮಿಕಲಿ ವಿ ಗ್ರೋನ್ ಅಪ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ depending upon the cost. Okay, so these are the some of the advantages over how we are going to use the smart transmitter in recent trends. Okay, so this is about the smart fresher transmitter or smart or intelligent sensors we are going to use in the transmitter. Okay, so in next class we will discuss the RVDT. Okay, rotary variable differential transmitter. Okay, so thank you one and all. If you have any doubts, please feel free to contact me. Okay, thank you.